एटलीस्ट यू वेक अप, स्टार्ट द सर्विस एंड फिनिश योर
या
योर टास्क, डेली टास्क. ओके, बिकॉज इट इज गोइंग टू टेक टाइम. आवर सेशन इज गोइंग टू ओनली 15 मिनट्स, 50 मिनट्स. या We'll see if the server is taking too much time to respond for each action. We'll separately install without class. We'll separately install this update manager and another server like that.
So generally in live environment, so how much power capacity they use for this server, this
What is that? I didn't get you.
the real-time what is the capacity of the server they use it for this vSphere center, vCenter server?
What is the configuration of vCenter server?
Yes.
Yeah, 24 GB and 8 CPUs.
Okay.
That too, it is only vCenter server. PSA control will be there on separate server. VC server will be there. DB component is running on another server.
Okay.
In this particular server, DB also running, right?
Right.
DB is also very disk intensive and memory intensive application, DB. That too, we are installing 2 DB components on this server.
Yes.
One is V plus plus, another one is this SQL Express. So multiple applications are running on the same memory configuration. That's a issue here. Minimizes the services window. This one also. And the other one also. Click no. Minimize this one also. Don't click, don't click.
Can I click cancel here? No, I think
Yeah,
we need to know this. I think till now it installed MS SQL Server. Now it started vSphere Object Manager installation.
okay, click okay. Window. select download, leave the download option, because once installation is done, it is going to download. Okay, next. Login credentials, administrator at vSphere.local. Yes, it is a database, it is a selecting component, port settings, what is the ports are required. Yes, I have internet connection, I want to configure proxy server. Proxy server in the sense, if for example, directly internet is not coming, there is a proxy server. We need to configure proxy server to connect the internet. As it is directly connecting, able to download the patches, internet able to connect, no need to select the checkbox.
Okay.
Click next. It is a default components location of path installation. Click next. What is this? Please space. What is this error is all about? It requires a 120 GB, but the server is having a C drive has 80 GB and one more drive is 40 GB. Why it is showing is 120 GB is in the sense it is going to download the all patches like whatever the ESXi hosts are available, it is going to download all the patches. That's the reason it is requires this much space. Now it is not required, just it is in a warning. You can proceed, click OK and proceed next. Check the task manager, is still 100% both CPU and memory? Oh, okay. Again, it is going to close. Huh? Minimize this. Let's see if it is complete. 5 minutes, that's fine.
Okay.
We'll cover the identity source again tomorrow.
Okay.
The identity source is not going to take much time, just 5 minutes.
Mm.
And we'll proceed with the rest of the topics.
Okay.
And nothing is there, other options we already selected, we already provided all the options during the installation. So
mm-hmm.
This last 5 minutes, that's fine, more than enough. I'm going to trim that
okay. Mm-hmm.
Video. Will increase the memory for this server.
Okay.
Once the installation is done, we'll shut down the server.
Mm.
and increase the memory from 16 GB to 24 GB or 32 GB.
Okay. So 24 into 1.5. So again, we have created another 40 GB.
No, 40 GB is there, the drive is there. So 32 GB in the sense,
32,
more than is fine. Certain, up to certain extent, no need to follow 1.5 basic concept.
Okay.
If the physical memory is too low, then the virtual memory is required. Otherwise, for 32 GB RAM, 24 GB RAM, virtual memory is not going to be useful that much.
Mm-hmm.
Let's finish. And exit, that is the installation done. vSphere Server Update Manager is done. Now the vSphere Update Manager service is going to start the download. It is going to check in predefined timings. We can shut down the server now, no issues. Once we start, whenever we start the server, it is going to check the internet to download the packages. There is no dependency. It will activate automatically at the background. So what we are going to do is we are going to shut down the server and increase the memory. Initiate a shutdown server and increase the memory for from current memory to 24 GB or 32. We'll increase to 32 GB. Force shutdown. Go to 31, ESXi host 31. Right click on vCenter server. Edit settings. Once server is down, we can get an option to increase the memory. Click OK. Currently server is online, so there won't be any option to increase the memory. Once server is down, we just are going to increase this memory from 16 GB to 32 GB. That is all about this session. The next session we'll discuss about identity source and other VC functions. How to connect vCenter server, what are the options, navigating the different functions. Minimize, close this console.